Part 26, we are going to discuss about the family topic. It will be there in the sociology subject for JNM first year students. Okay, in this we are going to discuss about Child Marriage Restraint Act. Okay, Child Marriage Restraint Act, it will be started in the year of 1929. Okay, the Child Marriage Restraint Act system, we are also called as the one topic, that is the Sarda Act. Okay, Sarda Act also called as Child Marriage Restraint Act. Child Marriage Restraint Act also called as the Sarda Act. Okay, these acts will be started in the year of 1929. Okay, why the act will be started means for prevention of childhood marriages. Okay, once the child, okay, once the girl will having 15 years of age group, she is eligible for marriage. Okay, before 15 years of age group, children not eligible for marry. Okay, the government or this type of Sarda Act will give some type of advices, suggestions to the parents. Okay, don't do childhood marriages. Okay, never encourage childhood marriages. Why? Because you are doing childhood marriages means your child only suffering after marriage. Why? Because she is not having any idea or any development. Okay, how to move, how to adjust in the husband family. Okay, why? Because she is a child. Okay, for prevention of childhood marriages, for protection of children from the childhood marriages, this Sarda Act will be started in the year of 1929. Okay, in this act they are giving some criteria for women and men. Okay, the child, the woman will be there means she has 15 years for marry. Okay, above 15 years she is eligible for marry. Below 15 years, some families, some traditions, some joint families will be encouraged. 9 years of age group children, so they are encouraged for doing marriages. Why? Because opposite family, that is a husband family or having a good income, he has one job. Okay, like that they are doing one encouragement. The husband means the groom having the 20 to 30 years of age group, but this type of bride having 9 years, 8 years. Okay, thus the family members will agree for giving marriage. Okay, they are agree or they are having proposal for doing marriage with the 30 years of age group groom to 9 years of age group bride. Okay, for prevention of these problems, this Sarda Act will be there in the society. For protecting children, for protecting girls, for protecting boys. Okay, sometimes the boy who is that groom is there, the groom will have the certain age group, that is the 18 years. Okay, after 18 years only he is eligible for marriage. Okay, before 18 years he is not eligible for marriage. Okay, this is these rules, this criteria will be there in the Sarda Committee or Sarda Act. Okay, next another one we will discuss about widow marriages. Okay, what is meant by widow marriages means once the woman, first she has undergone one marriage with the one husband. Okay, due to some reasons the husband will be death. Okay, the husband will be died in the early stages. For example, in the child marriages, what happens means at the age of 9 years of age group, the woman will be married, undergone marriage with the 40 years of age group men. Okay, the 40 years of age group men will die due to the some reasons. Okay, he is death. Means in these widow marriages, what happens means the woman who is having this type of widow means their husband will be lose due to the death of husband. Okay, this is one type of second problem in the Hindu culture. Why? Because she did not undergone remarriage. Why? Because she is widow. Okay, once she lose their husband due to the death or due to the compulsory death. Okay, due to that reasons, the women will be suffering. Means in the early stages, she lost their husband, means she is not fulfilling any sexual needs. Okay, due to that reasons, the some broken families, some widow families having some type of prostitution. Okay, this is the one reason. Next, in this what happens means, main widow marriages, this Hindu culture, the woman does not undergo remarriage system. Okay, once she lose one husband means she is not eligible for marrying of second husband. Okay, next some restrictions is there. Okay, once you lose your husband means you does not marry second time. Okay, this restriction will be coming by the some act. Okay, next another one is the medical aspects of marriage. What is the legal aspect? What is the criteria for marriage? What are the advantages is there in the marriage? Means first one is the physical health. Okay, first who is undergoing or who is eligible for marriage means physically healthy. Okay, woman, men. Okay, both physically healthy. They are not having any problems. Okay, they are healthy means then only we are conducting a marriage. Okay, we are not doing marriage for the patients. Okay, bedridden patients we are not encouraging for the marriage, no. Okay, who are the healthy persons is there in the society? Okay, those persons are committed to marriage each other. Okay, next another one is the mental health and happiness. Due to the marriage, they are improving their mental health. Okay, mentally healthy means they are reducing their depression, tension, anxiety, and they are improving their happiness by sharing wife and husband, by communicating couples. Okay, by opening, once the wife having some problems means the problems will be solved by the husband. Okay, once the husband will be having some struggles means that struggles will be relieving by wife. Okay, due to these reasons, due to this process, the couple will having the good mental health. Okay, they are having good happiness by the having children. Okay, due to that children, they are forgetting their tension, anxiety, fear. Why? Because the kids doing so many activities. Okay, so many activities they are doing, that particular activity they are receiving some love and affection, they are providing some happiness, they are receiving some happiness by the children. Okay, this is the one legal aspect. Another one is the this marriage is a one type of cohabitation. Okay, in this what happens means due to the marriage bonding relationship, unknown woman, unknown man living together. Okay, before marriage they are not having any relationship. Sometimes they are not having any relationship, they are not having any communication. Just once they are understanding, once or twice they are seeing, and they are deciding dowry system, and they are undergone restriction of elders, and they are living together with the bonding relation of marriage. Okay, they are able to produce children and they are eligible for living together with the bonding relation of marriage. Okay, once the woman marrying with the one man means the society will give some certificate means like they are calling their couples. Okay, due to the marriage system only. Without marriage, the woman and men living together means the society not accepted. Okay, for participating sexual intercourse. Okay, once they are marrying means the society will give freedom for participating sexual intercourse. Okay, this is the medical legal aspects regarding marriage. Okay, another one is the selection or protection. Okay, in this the wife will be protected by the husband. Okay, the husband will selected their wives. Okay, the wife will be protected by the husband will be protected by the wife. Why? Because she only give complete care to their husband. Okay, the husband only give complete care to the wife. Okay, they are sharing love and affection, they are protecting each other. Okay, next another one is the marriage will give the wealth. Okay, what is mean by wealth? Means in this they are doing work together and they are improving their income status. Okay, once the woman or the wife will having one government job means she has an income. Okay, the income, the property will be eligible for both husband and wife. Okay, or one husband having one government job or a good property means the property will be belongs to the wife and husband. Okay, both couples will be sharing their income status for fulfilling their basic needs or for reducing their problems or preventing their struggles. Okay, the income will be sharing each other. Okay, by the marriage only. Next, another one is the marriage will give one offer for producing children. Okay, without marriage, they are not having any opportunity for producing children. Once they are married, once they are having one bonding relationship means, then only they are eligible for producing children. Okay, next, another one is the marriage having the reducing crime or aggressive behavior. Means, once the wife having negative behavior, aggressive behavior means some advices, some guidance will be given, some health education given by the husband to their wife for modifying their negative behavior, for reducing their negative behavior. The husband will give some type of teaching how to reducing or how to modifying their domestic violence behavior. Okay, next another one is the marriage is the society. Okay, in this marriage society, what happens means in the society, after marriage only, the wife and husband will be living together. Okay, this will be accepted by the society. Okay, they are not having marriage, but they are eligible for producing children means the society not accept. Okay, in the society, these are best couples or those are couples like that when we are calling means they are having one bonding relationship, that is the marriage. Okay, these are the medical legal aspects regarding marriage. Okay, thank you.